Most people, when they hear that we have an aquarium, they visualize a classroom with a couple of tanks in there. But when they come and actually see what we have, they're pretty blown away because of the scope of what we're doing. This is where the magic happens, right here. We have a plethora of marine life.
The main floor of the aquarium is over 5,000 square feet and houses more than 25 exhibits. The one-of-a-kind facility is located at Cabrillo High School in the central coast town of Lompoc.
Once a month, we host an evening open house to the community at large.
Hi, welcome to the Cabrillo Aquarium.
It's just a great way for the community to see what the students are doing and what we're all about here at the Cabrillo High School Aquarium. We're hosting over 7,000 visitors a year, and the students are the tour guides. As advisors, we just kind of step back and let them take over and run the show.
And that little red dot right there, that is Point Conception, right next to our near and dear town of Lompoc.
The students, basically, they do everything. At the beginning of each school year, there's a pretty intensive training period in terms of how to do the, you know, the husbandry techniques and what the different roles are. But you can still feed them again, yeah, because they digest pretty quickly.
Whenever I say I work in an aquarium, my head curator, they're like, oh, okay, so like there's a tank and you're the guy who cleans the tank. No. I'm one of the few students who are in charge of a multi-million dollar facility. Okay, you guys are buddying up. Do you have a job yet?
Not yet.
I don't think anybody has estuary yet, if you want to cover that tank. This aquarium is the real deal. There's nothing like it. I know, I Googled how many aquariums are in high schools. I couldn't find anyone.
There's just a really cool synergy where students have to work together with one another. The hands-on component is the most powerful part. They feed the animals. They take care of the exhibits. There's times where, you know, something breaks down, and it's a great opportunity for a student to learn how to fix things like that. If you don't do that, animals are gonna suffer. You know, animals would die.
The animals definitely depend on us, and it's a huge responsibility to have to watch out for all these different animals that live in these tanks, and then even hatching like baby sharks, for example. That's a very difficult task.
The ability of us to have animals breeding in captivity is really a testament to the job that the students are doing.
I think that's a hermit crab over there.
We're not trying to crank out marine scientists. Honestly, this is a training program.
So talk about that, definitely. Besides that,
a big part of their job is they got to train the next generation. And not only that, they got to get them interested in wanting to take on that responsibility and carry the baton and keep the program growing and improving every year.
The aquarium started modestly in 1986 with the vision of one teacher, Dave Long. Through private donations and grants, Dave's dream has grown from a small club to a program with more than 200 students enrolled in classes that cover topics like tourism, marine science, and aquarium operations.
Good job, guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Cabrillo High School Aquarium is a passionate part of my life, and I'm extremely proud of it. And the reason that I am is to see the students that work in here.
Hi, how are you?
One of my favorites.
Oh, thank you.
It's overwhelming to come and then see it continue to perpetuate itself through these students.
All right, hey guys, so my name is Naomi.
I'm Natalie.
When we see young people and they're talking to little children about what they're passionate about, there is no teacher that could give them the same message as those high school students who those young people look up to and admire.
All right, hey there, scuba kiddos. My name is Kaylee and I am your scuba expert for the day.
It's really wonderful to be able to work with the kids of our community.
For some of these children, it's their first time they've ever had an encounter with water or the ocean itself. So for me to be able to show them how wonderful it is and how much there is to learn about it is awesome.
Perfect, they're all ready for us.
I've had anywhere from a kid smiling, saying, "You made my day. I really love the ocean a lot more now," to, "I'm going to go to Cabrillo High School because I want to be like you and work in the Cabrillo High School Aquarium."
I'm so excited that I have the pleasure of diving with all of you today.
We just give the best experience to the kids that come through. We can really change lives.
Do any of you know what an adaptation is?
Yes.
Getting used to like a certain place.
Awesome.
I think I definitely wouldn't be the person I am today. The aquarium has really grown a lot more confidence in myself. As I was growing up, I had a bad speech impediment, and I actually had learning disabilities as well. But working in this aquarium has just shown me, just if you really want to do something, you'll be able to achieve it no matter how hard it seems that it may be. My junior year, I lost my dad to stage 4 cancer, and I really wanted to give up. When I learn more about the ocean, it makes me feel that I may be closer to my dad. He always told me to never give up, like share your passion, do as much as you can, and that's where I am today.
It is so satisfying to me to see students grow and develop and rise. They come in here and they just, a spark is like lit. They are capable of doing such amazing things, and they just need opportunities. This aquarium, it's a tool. It's a tool for students to be able to take their learning to a whole new level.
Of the animals at the Cabrillo High School Aquarium are native to the nearby Central Coast. That includes cartilage fish like horn sharks and swell sharks, as well as bony fish like surf perch and sculpins. The aquarium also features thornback rays, as well as invertebrate animals like sea cucumbers, sea urchins, sea stars, and corals.